Okay, let us welcome you all again to resume our session. So just I'll give you small recap about the sessions which we have seen earlier. So let us have small recap about what we have discussed so far. So here we have started with introduction to IP. What is intellect and what is property, followed by we have proceeded with how our human brain should work or how it is working to have the better innovative product. So this is the one is the key for developing innovative products. So likewise, we have seen the few inventions which is developed by the famous inventors, followed by we have seen some of the creative thinking boosters or technique to increase our creative thinking, and followed by we have seen various forms of IP or variants of IP. We started with patents and other forms of IP, and slowly we have getting into the one form of IP, that is patent, and how it should started with. As we are keep discussing, all the IP started by the base of idea or at the stage of ideation. With that, now we understood the prime importance of doing the prior art search. As discussed in the earlier classes, I have mentioned that we need to go for prior art search before filing any patent, and also I have given small glimpse about what is the necessity of doing patent search. And now we'll proceed with how our Google search engine response or work respond for our keyword which we are typing in. Let's see very small demo, and I have given one more hint that whenever we are developing a product, we need to understand how the keyword should be selected. I'll take you through a small demo using our normal Google search. This is even applicable for patent database search as well. So let me take you through one basic example. My core aim is to search for the specific brand with the red ballpoint pen. That is the task I have undertaken. But generally, we people will start search by using the keyword only pen. Let me take you through the Google search. You see, I have simply given a keyword stated pen. Can you see how many hits? It's around 141 crores of search hit has been arrived in just 0.44 seconds. Just imagine, you or anyone will think of developing invention related to pen? Just have it as a question. So now how I need to take it further? Let me give another example. My focus is towards ballpoint pen. Okay, now I am including that as a keyword to the search. See the result. Now I have given ballpoint pen as the keyword. Okay, it hardly comes around 2.84 crores hits in just 0.43 seconds. So this is how the variation comes in, right? There it is 141, now it's become 2.84, but still it is not easy to develop invention with 2.84 2.84 crores hits. Let me give another keyword which is very specific, or I can say it's little more narrow down towards our invention. That is, red ballpoint pen of specific brand is my requirement. I am just including the term red ballpoint pen. Can you see now how it works? It is 1.35 crores. It's become almost half by including the specific keyword red into the search engine. You see, I hope you can understand this, I am just using the keywords which is very, very close to my invention. I am taking towards the closest, or I can say narrowing my invention through the keywords. This is the technique which we need to understand over here. Now still I can refine by using the specific brand name. For example, there are so many pen brands like Parker, etc. Here my focus is about Rorito red ballpoint pen is my core reference which I have chosen for my search. Now you could see the search results. It's completely came down in terms of thousands. Now we got only 70,300 hits for our red color Rorito brand ballpoint pen. I have fixed this as my core invention for the processing of my new patent or invention. Here I can term it as patent itself because it's purely a product. Even I can stress and say this is the functional product. We need to know which functional part, or I can say very specific functional part, should be addressed for particular invention. Okay, here the key comes in. I would like to ask you, still 70,000 hit is not the feasible one, right? We cannot narrow down out of 70,000 to one by the product which I would like to develop. What shall I do? Here you shouldn't use further keywords, but using some specific symbols, or I can say codes, to which can consolidate or narrow down our search further. Here I'll show you how the Google has worked till this point of time. Now initially I have used the keyword pen. It will look for pen wherever it appears. For example, even few may mention computer stylus also as a pen. Olden days we use some stick, by touching that stick in the ink we are writing, even that might be mentioned as a pen. That is the reason why wherever it has appeared, it shows the hit of around 141 crores hits. Again, while using the second word ballpoint pen, it is neglected all the ink pen which is shown in the previous search. That is pen which covers, or I can say it completely comprises of all the variants of pen, including ink pen, gel pen and ballpoint pen. But herein we have completely converged to ballpoint pen alone. So my search reduced further. I have moved closely towards my invention. Further, I'm not worrying about the other colors. I'm going to bother only about red ballpoint pen. Again, the Google works in this manner. It works only for red color ballpoint pen, and it neglected other color pens. For example, blue, green, yellow or black and so on. So this is the way we are need to address the Google's for the search engine. We need to give the specific, very, very specific keywords towards our invention. That increases the effective search outcome. So further, I have narrowed down to specific company. the company I have chosen here for the assessment is Rorito. It's a kind of a pen producer, and I have converged for them to the red ballpoint pen alone. Now the search engine worked in this fashion, but still I can refine this search without increasing the keywords with some specific symbols. Most of you might be knowing this. If you don't know, look at this. A simple double quote is further reduce your or further narrow down your search. I can show you the difference between the previous one and this one. There it looked for Rorito red ballpoint pen. In some cases, Rorito red ballpoint is included in that particular search, but in this case it always looks only for the ballpoint pen as a single keyword. In the previous one, it is considered as a two different keywords. Even we can have in this manner Rorito red plus ballpoint plus pen, it would have searched for, but now it is searched only for the Rorito red ballpoint as a single component. You can see the difference very well now. It was around 70,000 over there, now here only 18,700. Even the hit time also considerably reduced. So still I can further reducing this using the same keyword, that is Rorito within double quotes red ballpoint pen. Can you just think about this search result? It's only 477 hits only. So think about it, how versatile we are narrow downing, or I can say with a simple keyword search we are bringing down, or we are moving towards the invention. This plays a major role. Now think about it, is it easy for us to work with 477 hit results or with almost 70,000 hit results? Here also see, I have not even changed or added any more further keywords. Please be clear with this. This gives the complete easiest way to move very very close to our invention. Even you can see in the search results itself that red ballpoint pen appears together, Rorito appears separately, and you can see even it is in the search result, you can see the first search result myshop.rediff.com, you can see after the word dark red ballpoint pen showing as a single keyword. That is the major advantage of using double quote symbol, right? We are not using any some complex coding systems or any other thing to narrow down our search. Simple double quotes are making us very very close to our invention, right? Now it is easy for us to think about the innovation with 477 results. I'll give one more example also, because here I have used a single component. For example, if you are going for a multiple component, a single product, that is assume one car or a bigger component or bigger vehicle, therein our invention is very very specific about searching the engine. Even I can say inside the engine only piston or piston rod, right? That is my only search. For that, how you need to give the keyword, that is the question. The keyword here you need to give us, first you need to add the component, it is car, or if you want that engine can be fitted in any other vehicles, even you can remove the word car, go to the engine plus engine piston rod plus what you are going to do. For example, if you are enhancing that feature or the methodology or adding some component or deleting some component, for sure, if you follow this technique, you can narrow down the search in a effective way. Even with this pen, I can further narrow down. If assume that with this red ballpoint pen itself, I am just going to add the ballpoint pen with ink as variants. For example, the refill initially contains only thicker one and followed by the thinner one, followed by thinnest one. If I'm using the same refill, right? If I'm doing any alteration along with this red ballpoint pen, I need to use the keyword refill as well, because that refill take you to the invention very, very closer. Hope you can understand how you can narrow down your search. Why we need to stress in this part very, very in a deeper manner. Again, here you need to look in a little deeper about this search, because generally if you give some keywords in random, mostly our keywords may not be appear as such, right? Even I can say there are some alternative keywords also required for this. Alternative in that sense, generally I'll give one example and then I'll move into that. For example, if you are going to develop a pen, mostly we people will search only for looking for the pen and related accessories, but it is not necessary that only pen is the word used to represent pen. Hope you understand. Even pen can be synonyms of that might be used by other inventors or people, those may use this other keywords for this pen itself. For example, pen can be represented by the word or by the statement, for example, writing device, writing equipment, or even in a much complex way, like it is a device used to convert my thoughts in the form of a words, that is also representing pen, right? Can you understand the difference now? So it is not easy for us to state some invention which is not existing, right? We need to undergo vigorous search before taking into patent filing. That is the reason why I'm giving more tests at this point itself. If you find your inventions are repetitively using here and there, please avoid taking to the stage of filing itself, because that will land up in waste of money, right? I'll let you know the registration fees in the upcoming sessions. I'll give the complete detail how much you need to pay everything. In that case, you can save minimum of filing fees of 9,000 rupees to the as a government filing fees, right? So you can understand now that how the search can be did in the elaborated or detailed manner. Now, hope you understood that search should be carried out with precise keywords. I would like to give the example. Even I have mentioned this in the previous session itself, how the kids address the doll to buy. If you ask any kid, it never state that I need some monkey toy or I need that car. It is very, very specific that I need red color monkey with black color tail and blue eyes. Likewise, we need to give our keyword as precise as we should be and use the inverted technique or the inverted commas to highlight the main components, or I can say the primary components, to go ahead with narrow downing your search further. Okay, then you can see the art of patent search. Now you can see only in the common Google database. Now we are going to assess about the different types of patent databases those available for us. Even I will take you through different search methodologies and as well some free and paid databases which are existing in this particular pattern search. And first I'll let you know what is the effectiveness of pattern search. Let's see the first one. The correct result is not always immediate. Hope you understood this point clearly, because mostly the way we use the keyword, it's always matters. Please understand that, because if we are using the random keywords, it never ever work in the better way. And also we cannot land only with the specific keywords. For sure we need to look for the keyword synonyms, also the alternative keywords, or we can say related keywords also should be taken into consideration. If you are giving in this fashion, mostly search results won't be immediate. If somebody is claiming that within a day I can give search results, that might not be true always. They might give, but might not be true always, because it's need rigorous refinement. Even I can relate this even further more, because like search results may vary even day by day. Hope you understood that, because the database are keep updating, right? Even if I would have taken this search before 15 days or 10 days, the same pen keyword might give less number of hits. Hope you understand that, because the database updation also matters. And one more thing, no one can claim I can give 100% search result, because whatever the database we have, that is, all the database are not 100% updated. I'll put it another way, we'll go through in detail as well. For example, if you are filing a patent, right, be clear about it. There is a journal that is being published by Indian Patent Office, right, that we call it as publication of patent, that we term it as even stage 2. Stage 1 is filing and stage 2 is publication. The publication generally it takes 18 months time period. Be clear about it. It takes around 18 months time period, followed by we can increase, or we can say we can speed up the publication time by paying the extra fees to the patent office, right? If we are paying that extra fees, it will publish in the time period of minimum of 2 weeks. That depends upon the number of applications received. Even some applications may publish within a week also. That depends upon the number of application received by the patent office, right? So in that case, it may maximum it may take even 3 months also, right? That publication contains the all bibliographic details, your filing number and abstract, and who are all the applicants and who are all the inventors. All those details are get published, right? Why I am stating this is, please be clear, while we are doing a search, if the same invention is applied as a patent to the patent office, if we are searching during this week, that content might not be published. Hope you understand. Else, if the person who has not paid any extra fees for yearly publication, it will take 18 months. So those documents are considered to be gray documents. We cannot have any access towards those particular documents. Now you can understand that it is not easy, or it is not the way we can say 100% search results can be brought in for any invention. So please be aware of this. If somebody is claiming it is 100%, it is very, very hard to bring in 100% search results for any invention. Please be clear about it. And the second one is, we require to go for many iterations to obtain the suitable results that we have seen even in the demo what we have looked in previously. We cannot get the exact output for that particular invention in a single go. For sure, we need to work in for many iteration to get the required output what we are really seeking for, right? And third one, it is the common fact, search is an art. It can be learned over the period. Say for example, initially we all look in only for the, say assume the same keyword pen, we always look only for the pen or red pen or something like that. We never thought about searching or looking for writing device, but it is mandatory for us to look in for writing device, writing equipment. Even as I stated, it is a device which can convert our thoughts in the form of a words, or it is a medium to convert. It is a device and act as a medium to convert our thoughts in the form of the letters. So likewise, we can use n number of various keywords or statements to describe or express any invention, right? That for sure you need to know the effective way of addressing or searching the keywords. For sure you need specific time period to learn all this search methodology. Let me introduce some of the types of pattern search. Actually, we have some various types of pattern search, as we did as a keyword is one of the technique, and I will introduce some other techniques as well. This is the generalized technique followed by many all over the world. First, let me give the various types, but it is not restricted only with this five types. Please be sure about it, because there are different forms. Even individual patent agent or examiner might have developed their own way of searching the patent. All right, so there are common five criteria. One is patentability search, second one is infringement search, freedom to operate search, state of art search, and validity search. These are all the five common technique that is being used by many. Let me give very small gist about each and everything. First one is common patent search. It is pre-application search. As we know very well, what are the application that we have filed? It is very, very specific to patents. What are the application we have filed earlier, or which are all filed previous day before we did, are considered to be the pre-application for our invention. And the second one is validity search. As the term says, as I'll give one additional thing here, the patent is valid for 20 years. I just want to make you recollect this point alone, because its validity is very, very closely associated with the expired or valid patent. See, it is very clearly stating that validity patent means prior art search to check the validity of the search. It means that, for example, as you take the same invention pen, there are around some 20,000 inventions related to pen, assume. In that case, you can check all the 20,000 is still valid or few may get expired, right? We need to understand that, because if the patents are get expired, it is in the, assume it is in the public domain. What is the meaning of public domain? Anyone can use it, use that technology or invention, right? Generally, inventors, what they will do, they will further optimize their invention and file yet another patent for the same invention. They may optimize, but still the same technology cannot be patented again, or we cannot extend the validity as well. Once it is filed, it is valid only for 20 years. That is the default time period for all the patent, irrespective of Indian regime, right? If you may think if you file in Chennai, it may vary, or file in Mumbai, it may vary. Nothing like that. It is valid only for 20 years from the date of filing. You can take many examples. Even 3D printer patent expired in the year 2005, but you can see there are n number of patents filed after that, but it is not with the same technology. The technology might be modified, or they may add the value to it to bring it as a better invention. So what is the use of doing this validity check or validity for our invention? If you are doing it as a validity pattern search, that enhances the way or efficiency that we can brought into our invention. We might have thought that still that pen has better in our perspective, but if you look at for this validated expired patent, that is validity expired patent, we might have further improve our products. That is the main advantage of looking for validity patent. Even I'll give the same example itself, the 3D printing. People might have thought even in the year 2005 it is our good invention, because during that time no one has used as they are using now, but it is published or it is granted as a patent long back. It is expired in the year 2005, but people after it is expired, they understood and they have modified. They might not go for the old technique itself. Can you understand? This is the core identity of going ahead for validity search. And the third one, state of art search. This is for, you can see that, new technology in the field of interest, or we can say literature survey, or the existing solution. What is the basic difference? For example, as I said, we need to consolidate all the existing patents related to that particular technology. Even few companies or a few database sellers, they have this particular work that has been consolidated and giving to us. Even you can buy it for some few dollars by paying money. Herein, that particular invention, for example, assume the same 3D printer. The 3D printer can be consolidated, for example, till since 2019-80 till date, they can consolidate all the patents that is published related to 3D printing. It is very, very easy for us. If we consolidate and came out with a new solution, it is easy for us to validate, right? That is the most important while doing state of art pattern search. And next one, FTO, we call it as freedom to operate. This is more I can say related to the commercialization aspect, clearance to search to commercialize. For example, in our area there are some few vendors of that particular product. We are thinking that, okay, why can't we bring that particular product to our area? During that time we can assess the existing products related to that particular invention what we are working with. We can assess that for the commercial viability of the patents. For example, even I have seen one question related to this. I have mentioned that what is the use of filing a patent for the very, very low cost inventions. This adds value here. See, for example, assume even we can say some of the examples as well. For example, earbuds. Earbuds, if you take a single unit, it may cost only 50 paise or even I can say 1 rupee, right? But our filing fees itself comes around 9,000 rupees, right? What is the use in this? Whether he can gain it or not. But if you file it as a patent, no one can enter into the market because this protects other from utilizing the patent what you have filed. Or I can say in other word, some of the competitors may not enter into it. Similar way, if there are few vendors in the market, they are using some technology, we are upgrading it, and we are working with the innovative outcome and we are patenting it, again no one can enter in our own business, or we can say we can reduce the competition by doing this freedom to operate search, right? This varies to area over area, I can say vicinity over vicinity, because it's based on the locality where we are residing in or where we are planning to establish the company, right? And now we are moving to infringement search. It is very specific pattern search about the claims part. I will take you through all those different content should be there in the patent. There you can understand this entire process. Now you understand only one term. In patent, there is a core unit called claims, or I can say this is the art of your invention. You understand there is a set of content should be there in the claims as well. As of now you understand this, I'll take you further about the rest of the content so that you can understand easily. Now you can see this infringement word means very simple little colloquial term for infringement is copying. That's it, nothing more than that. If we have copied some invention, or I can say if some expired patent or unexpired patents, if you are copying some content from the existing one, this search will exactly identifies that, because as I mentioned in the morning, we term the term called inventive step. If your patents in this particular claims lacks inventive step by doing this infringement search. I even highlighted one more point over there. If there are assuming 10 patents you are taking in, one claims from every patent and we are combining it and delivering it as a new patent, therein this issue raised, right? We term it as infringement search. This is specifically for unexpired patents. They look in very easily and those database can be corrected and that can be converted in the and reported in the form of the infringement, right? I think you don't want to confuse more about this. You simply follow the keyword technique as of now. That is more than enough, or I can say sufficient to work initially. Even I'll take you through the different databases that will assist you in a better way. The last one generally they follow is landscape search, or we can say landscape and themescape analysis. What actually it means? For example, assume the same product pen. I can identify in India how many patents are filed and how year wise it is distributed. That we call it as generally landscape and themescape analysis or landscape search. We can identify the business competitors directly, because you know very well none of the companies will introduce the technology without filing the patent. So this clearly retrieves, or we can say this clearly identifies who are all our competitors. All these are available in the paid databases. In free database we can consolidate and take this one effectively, and this analysis is available even in WIPO search engine, World Intellectual Property search engine. I'll take you to that one as well now. So these are all the different formats or types of pattern searches that are available. Now we'll specifically go how it varies or how it works. As I said, there is no concern for, or I can say, converged outcome for this pattern search. There is another keyword which you need to understand for doing the effective database search, that is international pattern classification number, right? And you need to understand one more thing. This pattern classification number, IPC, is not restricted one for that particular one product. I'll let you know the reason as well, because some products may cover in the different aspects. For example, assume the same pen, the ink may comes under the chemical product. It has different IPC code. So while filing a patent itself, we can easily understand if it is a broader classification, which IPC code should be selected for our own purpose. Here I give the same example pen. For pen, the IPC is B43K, that is the most preferred and used. And even there is another classification code, that is CPC, Cooperative Pattern Classification. This is jointly developed by European and US. They are following this code as well. Even if you file any patent, even it is an Indian patent or US patent or UK patent, you can very well see this code that exists along with the patent. Even in Google search itself, you can see this classification code. I suggest you strongly go ahead along with the pattern classification number search. For sure, it will further narrow down your search effectively. For example, our old example is pen with 477 hits. If you go with this particular IPC code, it will further reduces to might be around 100 or 150. So it is very, very easy for us to do the effective invention out of 150. So you can follow this always while doing pattern search. Let me introduce you some of the paid patent databases that is been available. One is Thomson Innovation, with the website also I have mentioned. Next is Quastel, and the website is orbit.com, and there are so many search engines available. And specifically those who are working for chemical, there is specific database for chemical structures search also. PubChem and ChemSpider, there are n number of databases available. Even there are specific databases like Patent Lens and PubMed. These are all some of the paid databases that will fetch you the results in the effective manner. It is not mandatory to search only in this. What is the advantage of going for patent paid databases? Okay, the major advantage of going for paid patent databases is you can get some of the relevant synonyms also highlighted and retrieved back. As I said, if you do it in free database, we are in a position to narrow down specifically. But here in the paid patent database, it automatically gives some synonyms output as well. That is the core advantage. If we are really good in, we don't want to use paid database, but if you are in the starting stage, it is recommended to go for this paid databases. It will easy for us to do the search effectively. Again, I'll show some of the free patent databases as well. USPTO, eSpaceNet. USPTO is, as the name says, it's for Americans. eSpaceNet is European one. And this is the one I was mentioning, WIPO, World Intellectual Property Organization. What is the core advantage of doing a search in this one is, this has some, I'll say, this act as a nodal person for the entire world. So it has signed a treaty in the name of PCT, Patent Cooperation Treaty. Almost 150 plus countries are being a part of the treaty, so they can easily work with and they can bring in the WIPO as a core database. You can consolidate all the 152 country database in a single platform. You can even note this one, patternscope.wipo is the effective, I can say, I cannot say it is effective, but it is the consolidated pattern database. You can very well use this one. As I mentioned, pattern lens is the next one. That is, both the versions are available, free version as well as paid version. And next one is free patterns online. This is also is another one. Herein you can include even the other articles. For example, any web related article also can be included as a search component in this. Even our well-known Google pattern search, in Google pattern search also we can include the other related articles as a part of it. And last but not least, our Indian patent services.gov, it will give the Indian patent database alone. As in, we have seen, the country based is specific for that particular country. US is for USPTO and European is ESPNet, and India is Indian patent services.gov.in. So similar way, if we can get only for that particular country, we can go ahead and searching in this kind of country specific database. But if you want as a whole, it is suggested to go for working with WIPO, World Intellectual Property Organization. So just a small glimpse about some of the patented software for your note. Here you can see the Google patents search. You can see the URL https://patents.google.com. Even you can see there below Google, you can see the patent identification. I have given one keyword, toothbrush, over there. And if you want, you can include the non-patent literatures as well. This is the one I was highlighting you, that for example, if you want to use the web articles also a part of it. And as we are well versed about the journals, if you want to include the journals, web article, even you can see that it mentioned Google Scholar itself, right? Journals, articles, patents, all combined together, and we can get the result. Even it is not so clear in that image, but in that image, it is in that search, it is showing first one is patent, second one is journal, and third one also, sorry, second one is also a patent, and third one is a journal. So likewise, it will figure out all the related inventions to that particular search what we are, or keyword what we are using. That is a major advantage of using these kind of free databases itself. This is the one I was mentioning. Herein it is talks about the Indian patent search, right? Shortly we term it as INPAS, Indian Patent Advanced Search System. How do we get into that particular thing? Even you can type only patent search, or you can type just Indian Patent Office. Just you type that, it will take you to ipindia.nic.in. Therein you can get the patent search as a single component. It open as a separate window for you. There you can see this ipindianservices.gov.in/public search. It will pop up the window what you are seeing below. There you can search in a elaborated way. For example, based on the particular items, whether it is published or granted, that is the top one. As a checkbox it appears, it is not so clear, but you can see very well. And the top one is published and granted, that is the step one. And you can search based on particular time period, 2019 to 2020 or something like that. Again, specific titles can be given, specific abstract you can search in for. For example, that keyword may appear only in title or particularly in abstract. Even we can categorize in that way. Again, in complete specification you can search, application number wise you can search, patent number wise you can search, and specifically applicant name wise you can search, applicant address wise you can search, inventor name, inventor address, filing office, PCT if you are filed, PCT application number. Likewise, all the categories are displayed over there. You can very well assess. Say for example, during the introduction I have mentioned that I have filed 55 patents. Do you have any proof? No. But if you use this system, if you search it, you can easily get all my 55 published inventions. So this is the way we can easily figure out whether it is existing or the data is not true, right? Complete assessment can be done. And one more thing I would like to highlight here, all these components can be searched as a single unit, or you can find and at the end of the search. You can combine also two or three units as a combined thing, and you can go ahead and search find. For example, I have one invention related to for example pen. You can give pen as the keyword in the title, applicant name as Balaji, and the filing office you may give Mumbai or Chennai. Then you can combine all three factors. You can type the captcha and give for a search. It will display the outcome in this combination as well. So you can go ahead for any type of combination which you are really looking in the Indian patent advanced search system. So this is the one I was mentioning about free patent online, right? This is one of the search engine. It's almost similar to USPTO, but in addition it includes some of the specific items. There you can easily see that US patent is given a check tick mark, followed by US patent applications, EP documents, abstract of Japanese patent, that is Japan, PCT you can include, German you can include, non-literature patents also you can include. Non-patent literature also can be a part of the search. One advantage herein is it will give along with the similarity index ratio. It will shows after if you there is a big box therein, if you click you type and click search, it will give some, assume it is giving some around 10 or 15 search, there you can find 100, or you can give 1000, 999, 988. Likewise, it will give the similarity index as a part of it. That might be useful for us to do the consolidation, or we can go ahead and read that particular document and we can find the relevancy. Some may comes with the relevancy index of 500 or 400. We may leave out those invention. We may focus up to the similarity index more than 50 years. Even as the Google patents has, here also we can give the range, all the years or last 20 years, or likewise we can give the search as well. Even you can see the set order. I have given the relevancy as the option which you have chosen. Relevancy in that sense, top relevant unit will comes in the number one position. For example, the similarity index or relevancy is 1000, right? That will comes in the first one. Slowly it goes in the descending order, right? It starts decreasing 900, 800, 700. Likewise, it keeps decreasing. The relevancy identification will help us in identifying the closest invention to us. And this is the one I was keep mentioning, that this WIPO patent scope. You can see again the similar field combinations are available even in WIPO patent scope, and even you can do a number of alternatives. One major advantage in using the WIPO is we can go ahead for having the analysis. Hope you may remember I was mentioning about the landscape and themescape analysis that you can easily work out over here. That is a major advantage. It displays in the form of a table, as well as we can convert it into charts as well. As I was mentioning, it will give the index in this form. For example, 100 patents filed, totally you have 100 patents, among which 50 patents filed by US and 40 by UK and 10 by India. Likewise, it will give the country wise variation as well as year wise. For example, started in the year 2000, 2002, 2020, every year how many patents are filed in that particular invention. All these variation can be easily obtained by this patent scope database. Along with that, it covers almost 153 countries, the entire database in a single platform, or I can say single database which covers all the 153 patent database. But here the only issue is you cannot get the non-literary patent items, only patent related database only we can look in the World Intellectual Property Organization patent scope search engine. And now it is left for Q&A.